Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss about hardness of water. The objective of this topic is to know different types of hardness in water, to know different methods for the removal of hardness. So let's see what is meant by hardness. Hardness of water is the amount of dissolved calcium and magnesium in water. When calcium carbonate present is below 60 milligram per liter, it is soft water. When it is 60 to 120 milligram per liter, it is moderately hard water. When the amount of calcium carbonate is 120 to 180 milligram per liter, it is hard water. And when calcium carbonates are above 180 milligram per liter, it is more hard water. Calcium dissolves in water when it passes over and through the limestone deposits. This will give the presence of calcium in water. Similarly, magnesium dissolves in water when it passes over the dolomite and other magnesium formations. There are two types of hardness, temporary hardness and permanent hardness. So let's see what is temporary hardness. Bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium will give temporary hardness. This temporary hardness can be reduced either by boiling or by addition of lime method. Permanent hardness. Permanent hardness is generally difficult to remove by the boiling method. Sulfate or chlorides of calcium and magnesium will give the permanent hardness. So to remove that permanent hardness, various methods are used. Let's see. The softening of water. Softening of water is the removal or reduction of hardness from the water. From health point of view, it is necessary to remove the hardness from the water because it requires more consumption of soap in producing leather and washing of clothes with hard water than soft water. The main advantage of water softening is reduction in the consumption of soap. If we consider industries, hard water also causes various types of troubles and difficulties in the industrial processing. The hard water forms scale in the boiler and it requires more quantity of fuel for the production of steam. Hence, to remove the hardness of water is very much essential. So let's see the need of the softening. Due to the various reasons, softening is done. The more quantity of soap is consumed at home and laundries for the washing of clothes. This is due to the reason that about 25 ppm additional soap quantity is required for every 1 ppm of hardness in water. The fabric of clothes gets spoiled while washing it to remove the precipitate formed by the soap in hard water. In industries, hard water forms scales in the boilers, due to which more fuel is wasted and boiler metals are overheated, which causes danger to the boiler plant. The hard water creates serious troubles in the manufacturing process of textile, finishing, paper making and such different industries. The hard water chalk and clogs plumbings due to precipitation of salts in them. Let's see the various methods for the removal of hardness. First, removal of temporary hardness. Temporary hardness is removed by the two methods, by boiling and by addition of lime water. So let's see what is boiling. When water is boiled having temporary hardness, the following chemical reaction takes place. After the chemical reactions, the calcium and magnesium carbonates are insoluble in water and these are removed by sedimentation tank. But this is very costly process and it is not possible to use in the waterworks. Second method, addition of lime water. If the water of lime is added in the water which contains temporary hardness, it can be removed by adding the lime water. This method is used only for the removal of temporary hardness. Then, removal of permanent hardness. The removal of permanent hardness from water is difficult and it requires the special methods and equipment. This method employed for the removal of permanent hardness from the water are known as water softening methods. For the removal of permanent hardness, lime soda process is used. If water contains the sulfates of calcium and magnesium, simply addition of lime cannot remove the hardness. But if soda ash is added in lime, the non-carbonate hardness can be easily removed. This method is known as lime soda process. In this process, lime reacts with the bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium to form carbonates and water. The calcium carbonate is insoluble and it is settled in the form of PPT. Magnesium carbonate reacts with the additional lime and it is converted into magnesium hydroxide, which is insoluble in water. Magnesium calcium sulfate and chloride reacts with soda ash and lime to form the insoluble precipitation. Lime is added in the beginning, which allowed to form the precipitation. The hardness, which is not removed by the lime alone, is removed by adding soda ash. There are various advantages of soda lime process. This method is very economical method. If it is combined with the sedimentation with coagulation, less quantity of coagulant is required. pH is also increased in this method and it reduced corrosion of pipe. The total mineral content of water are also reduced. Up to certain extent, the iron and manganese are also removed from the water. It increased alkalinity, which kills the pathogenic bacteria and reduce bad effects on disinfection plants. There are disadvantages too. It requires careful operation and skill supervision for its performance. It causes trouble in different filters. Large quantity of insoluble precipitation as sludge obtained proper disposal required. It can remove hardness only up to 50 mg per liter and it is good for drinking water, not for the laundry. Next topic is fluoridation. Fluoridation is the presence of fluoride in water. If the fluoride concentration in the treated water is less than 1 mg per liter, it will be harmful to the teeth as it will form fever cavities in the teeth of the children. For removing this harmful effect, extra dose of fluoride should be added in water to make it useful to the teeth growth of the children. The process of adding fluoride in the water is called fluoridation. The common compounds which are added in the water are sodium fluoride, sodium silica fluoride, etc. The actual required dose of fluoride should be carefully determined and added, because it has been seen that excessive dose of fluoride, more than 1.5 mg per liter, is harmful and it causes spotting and discolorization of teeth. Fluoride is widely used in USA for obtaining the actual dose of fluoride. Next topic is treatment of water with the copper sulfate. Copper sulfate helps in removing colors, taste and odors from the water. The main advantage of copper sulfate is it checks the growth of algae even before its production and it kills some bacteria. The algae, if gets time to grow and is killed after completing its life cycle, it will produce oils and other decomposing products which will produce objectionable taste and foul odors in the water. If the copper sulfate is added in time, it will prevent the growth of algae and will keep the water free from the taste and odors. It is usually added at the rate of 0.5 to 0.65 milligram per liter to the treated water before it is allowed for distribution in the main system. The solution of copper sulfate is generally prepared and it is added just at the entry of water in the distribution system. It can also be added in the clear water storage reservoirs. It can be added in the lakes or impounded reservoirs for the prevention of algae growth. But if its excessive dose is added, it will kill the fish and other water livings. Therefore, the quantity of dose should be properly determined. We should just check the growth of algae and do not kill the fish or any other aquatic life.